Good morning. My name is Jungsoo Kim from SK Telecom, and I'm in Network and IT Convergence R&D Center. Today, I'd like to talk about our OCP trial results for our infrastructure. So far, everybody seems like talking about the new technology or efficiency or performance of OCP gears. But I'd like to talk about the practical issues that we faced while we introduced and deploy OCP gears in our data center. So I'm going to briefly introduce our evolution of infrastructure and next generation of infrastructure, which is Cosmos, and our effort to open hardware and open software of SK Telecom. And I will share our trial results and the purpose of OCP trial and characteristic difference compared to hyperscales, and trial scope and details, and so on. So I think SK Telecom is the fastest adapter of new technology in the world. As the new technology evolved, our network and our data center also evolved from 2G to 3G, CDMA, LTE, 4G, from the siloed data center and to cloud data center. Now everybody is talking about the 5G, and which should be the old IT network. And we named our next generation infrastructure as a Cosmos. So Cosmos is composable, open, scalable, mission critical, optimized system. In top of the architecture, there's applications, OTT, telco application like LTE, low-rise IoT, 5G, and enterprise applications. So those applications should run under the cloud services. And there's software layers and hardware layers. In software layer, everything will be software-defined. Software-defined compute, software-defined storage, and software-defined network. And to orchestrate and manage those infrastructure, there's a control plane orchestrating layer to manage and to make automation of operation and monitoring analysis, something like that. And there's a physical infrastructure layer, servers, switches, storages. And we believe that those software and hardware should be open source, technology based. So we have put a lot of effort to open source and open source hardware and software community. Last year, we joined OCP as a gold member. And we are also the OCP Telco project co-lead. So we developed all-fledged storage server. We developed a server switch appliance. We developed NVMe storage servers. And we already submitted storage server and switch to OCP Foundation. And it's under IC review. And we also will contribute our storage NVMe array this year. We also, SK Telecom is also founder of Telecom Infra Project, and we are the board chair of TIP. So through the in the TIP, we are going to build community lab. And we are going to start TEAC program. TEAC stands for TIP Ecosystem Acceleration Center. And it will incubate local talent around the world and accelerate product development for telecom infrastructure. So I think those two numbers, 38% and 24% is the one of the most famous number in OCP community. And everybody has been passionate about the achievement that Facebook made. The purpose of our OCP trial in our data center is There are three main purposes. One is to verify OCP technologies, how efficient they are, and what is the performance, what is the serviceability of OCP gears. The second is we want to analyze the deployment environment, especially in South Korea. So from the vendor selection, procurement, IDC environment, and specification, and so on. And we also want to check OCP ecosystem in local, and what kind of vendor we can choose, what is the level of their technical support, and what is the delivery time compared to legacy 19G system. So we are different from the hyperscale, I think. To understanding of difference is very important to introduce new technology to your organization. So in terms of the volume, and before that, OCP gears, especially 21-inch racks and system, is designed for hyperscale and designed by hyperscale. In terms of the volume, hyperscale, they have more than hundreds of thousands of servers, but we have less than tens of thousands of servers. Age of data center, they are relatively young. Facebook is founded in 2000. SK Telecom is founded in 1984. So we have a lot of old facilities and old buildings. And data center, they have a huge, big data center all over the world. But we have small distributed data center in the country. Also, the management, they are very centralized. We have very separate management entities. And we still maintain 2G networks, 3G networks, and LTE networks. And we have a lot of stakeholders. So you have to talk with different entities to change infrastructure. And deployment, the hyperscale, they are rack-scale deployment. When they buy the system, the vendors or system integrators install the servers or storages in the rack before they delivery. But we buy sometimes a few servers or tens, maybe 100 servers at a time. So compatibility between rack and servers are very important for us. And the suppliers, they are hyperscales, ODM vendor suppliers to hyperscales, but we are brand vendors like HP, Dell, IBM. That makes a difference between hyperscale and SK Telecoms. So we selected three rack configuration to test various kind of applications in our IDC. OpenStack rack for private cloud, hard rack for big data analytics, and RAD rack to run telco applications such as NFV containers. The scope of a trial is from the selection of a vendor to operation environment. So we want to see, we not only want to see the performance and efficiency of the system, but we want to see the whole life cycle of OCP gears in local environment. So vendor selection, four vendors responded to our RFP, so we could only talk with the four vendors because there are among the four vendors, one vendor had a Korea office, two vendors had a local partner, but the other vendor hadn't entered the local market yet. So we assessed the vendors based on the credibility, technology, price, and technical support, and delivery time. As you look at the chart, vendor A was generally good, but they have a little bit long delivery time. Vendor B, the price was a little bit high. The vendor C, they offered the cheapest price to us, but the technical support and delivery time is not good enough. The vendor D, they hadn't entered the Korean market yet, so they had a high price, a long delivery time, and expert technical support. So we, so among the four vendors, we chose vendor A and vendor B for supplier of our OCP trial. And to test environment, to test performance and environmental test, we rented the crack test bed, which is about 1.5 hours away from the Seoul. The crack stands for computer room air conditioner, and they have a temperature humidity control system with cold air containment and 20 racks. And they have a server simulator, and they have a sensor and logos. This is the test design architecture. Among the three racks, we put the computers. We put the computer sled, 43 computer sled, in the open rack, and to compare between the legacy 9G system and OCP system, we also installed 19-inch, three 19-inch servers. So this is a top view. We installed temperature sensors front and rear side of the rack to measure inlet and outlet temperature of the server room. And we also installed a rack power monitor in both OCP rack and 19-inch legacy racks. So this is the actual picture that we implemented. So on the right-hand side, there's an OCP rack with a pole, which has three sensors. And also, there's a same sensor in front of the OCP rack. And the legacy rack also have the same temperature sensor. And it has the, it is in the cold aisle containment. So test details. There are main three categories we tested: performance, efficiency, and application. And performance and efficiency test is done at the crack test bed, and application test is done at our data center. So we measure the performance of our CPU and memory. Also, we measure and compare the power consumption between OCP system and legacy system under different room temperature and under different workloads. This is the result of a CPU and memory performance. As you can see, whether it's a vendor A OCP server, vendor B OCP server, or legacy system, if they have the same CPU and same memory, they have same performance. The reason that you should run performance tests before measuring power consumption is if there is a problem in the system or if there's a configuration difference, the performance will be different. So you have to make sure that you have the same configuration between test servers. This is the power comparison result. Under different room temperature. So we measured under 25C, under the different temperature from 25 C degree to 35 C degree. As you can see, whether it is the power consumption difference between OCP system and legacy system is about 20%. And as the room temperature rises, the efficiency also rises slightly. So under the idle state, the power consumption difference between OCP and legacy is huge. It's almost 50%. I think that's because OCP system has less fans and the formulas are very optimized in idle state. In the workload on the 100% extreme state, the power consumption difference drops slightly, but it was around 18 to 19%. And this chart shows we compared full rack configuration of open rack with half rack configuration of rack. We also wanted to compare vendor differences. So we run vendor A servers and vendor B servers independently. As you can see, the most power efficiency can be gained through full rack configuration. So if you compare the blue line with red or green line, there are about 3 to 5% of power efficiency difference between full rack and half rack configuration. Also, the vendor differences exist. Vendor, even if they have the same CPU, same memory, same configuration, same specification, vendor A was better than vendor B. So in summary, on general workload, OCP system is better, more efficient than legacy system, about 20%. And as the room temperature rises, the efficiency also rises. And there was a vendor difference between vendor A and vendor B. So you may need optimize your fan curve or power curve to optimize further. And lastly, to gain most energy efficiency, you should deploy full rack configuration. So after having performance and power efficiency test, we moved our three racks from test bed to our data center. So among the three candidates, data center A is the oldest data center, which is built early 1980s. So they reconstructed the office building to server room. So they had lower ceilings. They had a small flight elevator. We found that we cannot carry the open rack because the flight elevator is too small to carry. So we excluded data center A for application test. Data center B is the newest one. It's a cooler data center. Still, the entrance of the server room is lower than open rack. So, and data center C is constructed in mid-90s. It has the same problem with the data center B. If you look at the rack power, most of our data center of rack power provides about 6.6 kilowatt, which means that you cannot install as many as a server you can because of the limitation of the power. And it will reduce the energy efficiency also. Only the data center B could offer over 13 kilowatt of power. So this is the deployment issues that we had while we deploying the OCP gears, our data center. So the one of the principles of open rack is they have the same width with legacy 19-inch system. But it turns out that not only the width, but the height of the rack is matter. So since the open rack is taller than our traditional 19-inch rack, we had to remove the rack tray. We had to disassemble the containment. And our building is not high enough to carry the rack. So four or five others should take care of the rack to carry the rack in our server room. And as I said, the flight elevator is too small to carry. And there was compatibility issues. The vendor A and vendor B, the rack shelf is not compatible, which means you can't use a vendor A server to vendor B's rack. So to use vendor A's server in different vendors' rack, you have to change the rack shelf, which is really difficult to remove. So application test is ongoing in our IDC. And So in summary, throughout the full life cycle of deployment process of OCP years, we could experience many problems, but we confirmed that OCP servers are very energy efficient. Like in vendor selection, there was limited vendors and models we can select, and the technicians are unexperienced because they never seen the OCP system before. And it takes long communication time and long delivery time. And we found that the price of the OCP system is not stable, so there is a high deviation of purchasing price with, between the different vendors. And the size of the system is matter, and low rack input power reduced the efficiency, and there was the compatibility issues. And there was no serious problem while we configure, while we install on operating system application to OCP system, but VGA port may need it because the data center technician use KVM to manage servers. And there was no performance difference, and we confirmed that OCP system is very power efficient. So what can we do to solve those issues and to introduce a new technology to our data center? The vitalization of ecosystem is very important. And from our experience, organization consensus is also very important. So you have to closely talk with the operation. You have to closely talk with your data center experts. And before deploying the new technology, you have to make sure that everybody understands the difference between legacy and new system. And we had some compatibility issues, so we need further standardization of OCP system. So what is our approach? I think we are very beginning stage of open source hardware community. So the participation and collaboration and contribution is the key, and that is exactly what we are doing right now. So in the last, I'd like to introduce our next project. So we are going to build hardware management system. Because of the proliferation of new technology like AI and container, the management of hardware information becomes very important. For example, like a GPU server can easily consume over 2,500 watts, and the micromanagement of like power information about the power, fan, temperature is very becomes very important. So we want to expand management level and range of our data center. So we want to remove the vendor dependencies. There is a standard protocols like IPMI and Redfish, but still each vendor, there is a vendor dependencies on the information of from the BMC. So we want to provide standard API and standard API gateway to remove the vendor dependencies. And also, hardware management system will support various protocols for servers and switches like IPMI, Redfish, and SNMP, and OpenConfig, and like that. So still, we want to collaborate, especially in OCP Telco project members, to define standard API and to develop hardware abstraction layer and to reflect Telco requirement to our system. Right. So with that, thank you very much. If you have further questions, you can email me. Otherwise, do you have any questions? Right. Yes.
What are your observations in terms of failures, glitches, and, you know, hardware that didn't
perform? The number of system that we tested is very small, so it's hard to say the failure rate of the OCP gears. So you need to have a volumes to understand the failure comparison between 19-inch system and OCP system. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay.
Next speaker.
Thank you.